Hey guys, happy Tuesday! Thanks for coming in tonight. Thanks replay viewers for watching, and thank you YouTube viewers for coming in as well. YouTube viewers, if you'd like to participate in the live broadcasts of these, you can join me on Periscope. Just download the app to your phone and search for Penguin and Fish. I'm here every night at 9:30 p.m. Central. Hello, hello! We are going to continue tonight on the needle-turned appliqué. We've already got two little leaves in, and we've got two more basted all ready to go. Hey, Janet, thanks for coming in. When we're done, it's going to be this really pretty flower. It's called Dedication Roads by Alyssa Bongean. I'm not quite sure how to pronounce that, unfortunately. So here we go. Cute little flowers. I'm working on these little bits here. So, okay, I'm going to flip you around and we will get going. Hey guys, happy Tuesday. Thanks for coming in. Again, we are working through the Splendid Sampler Quilt Along. It's a year-long quilt along that's happening right now. We're about halfway done. It's completely free for right now. When the whole thing's over, come February, March of 2017, then it's going to be turned into a book. And at that point, I believe the patterns will be coming down. But right now, it's available for free at thesplendidsampler.com. There's over 20,000 people that are making these quilts. It's crazy. So you can come join me here. I'm here every night at 9:30 p.m. Central, and we're going through all of the quilt blocks for the Splendid Sampler. If you're new here, my name is Alyssa Thomas from Penguin and Fish, where we make lovely and quirky hand embroidery patterns and kits. I'm the author of Sew and Stitch Embroidery and a fabric designer. And like I said, I'm here every night at 9:30 p.m. Central, and then all these videos go up on YouTube afterwards at Penguin and Fish Movies. Just so if you want to look at a technique again or, you know, stitch along on one of these blocks. So, all right, I'm going to flip you around and we'll get going. Again, we are working on some needle turn applique tonight. All right, guys, flipping around. So here we are. I am having so much fun working on this needle turn. It's just, like I've been saying the last few nights, this design just felt so traditional that it just called for some needle turns. So I'm gonna get going right away. I'd love to be able to finish both of these guys tonight and also maybe start one of the outside little flowering stem guys. I have one right here. All my pieces are cut out already. They're not all basted on. But yeah, so I'd like to finish these four leaves here and get at least one of those guys started. I think that one's going to be the kind of challenge of this project, of this block. Just because it's got a lot of corners and it's pretty small. All right. I think that's plenty of thread. I'm only going to use one thread. We tried it with two. So we tried this block with, this piece with two threads, and this piece we did with just one. And the two threads is much more visible. Like you can see all the little stitches. Whereas with just the one single strand of thread, you can barely see where I stitched it all. So we're gonna keep going that route. And it was just easier. It was less fumbling around, and we're doing it that way. So I already have these basted down, and I'm just gonna get going. If you guys wanted to watch the last couple of videos, they're on YouTube, and I'll explain things more on there. I'm just gonna chill and work on these guys tonight just to kind of see if we can get it done a little bit faster. So let me know how your Tuesday went today. I actually had to look up what day it was right before I came on. For some reason, I'm like, I was having my head that it was Wednesday, but not yet, so that's good. I have stuff to do. I can't have the week be over already. Not that Wednesday is, over, but getting there. You keep thinking it's Wednesday too? Yeah, I don't know what it was. Like, right before I hit record tonight, I'm like, oh my gosh, is it Tuesday or Wednesday? And I had to check the, I had to check the computer that I'm recording this onto a computer, and I had to look at it quick to make sure what day it was. Oh, you cut out all the elephants. Yay! So are you doing those all needle turn, or are you doing it a raw edge, or let me know what kind of applique you're planning on using for those. That just sounds like a really neat project. I'd love to start an all applique project. I think that'd be fun. It'd be fun. Like, I'd love to start an all needle turn applique project. I think that'd be just a fun, ooh, blanket stitch infusible. Okay, that's awesome. I love a pretty blanket stitch around applique. But I'm kind of itching for just, it's not like I need another project, but I like the idea of a nice, relaxing, you know, in front of the TV, sort of watching, you know, right now it's Sherlock, but watching a bunch of series and just stitching away like this, the needle turn. I think that'd be just so fun. Oh, gotta get matching thread. I haven't done that style in a while. I did the fused it down, fused the applique pieces down, and blanket stitch for the seagulls. I don't know if that's what it was called, but you know those applique birds. I think they were seagulls. It was early. It was kind of in the first 25 or so. It might have been like in the first 15 maybe, but for that one I did blanket stitch around. Not many episodes up there longer. Yeah, I'm on the last one of season 2. So it's funny though, I watch these shows while I'm doing other work that doesn't require so much thinking. Like I was working a lot on my next fabric collection, and that's just kind of work. I don't have to make a lot of, you know, mental strain decisions. Like when I'm writing, I can't watch anything. I have to have my headphones on. But when I'm just working on the computer and doing pattern stuff, then I can watch stuff. But I'm basically just listening to it. So it's funny because I told John he should watch it, my husband, because I thought he would like the show. And so during dinner, we put the first episode on, and I'm like, wow, I didn't watch any of this, but I know everything that's happening. Because I basically was just listening and then glancing up every once in a while, but it's like watching it again when you actually watch it and not just listen. So I just put new nail polish on, and it's not completely dry yet. Are there any earlier blocks on YouTube yet? Oh, any of the really early ones? There are a few. It's funny. So I used to only have them on Periscope, and then Periscope, there was this website that would automatically record your Periscopes, and I had people going there, and then that site shut down. So I've been they had like a service where they would put it all up on YouTube for you. So I did that, but they came in all in a crazy weird order. So I'm still going through that, and you know, I have to put text in and title them and all that. So I'm not done with all that yet. And it came in all in a different order. So I do have some earlier ones up, but not all. I'm kind of just going down the list and putting them in. So it's kind of funny. So there's some old ones from before we were doing the Splendid Sampler, and then some early Splendid Sampler ones, and then all my new ones too. Yeah, I just, now that I'm done with my fabric collection, I'm hoping that I can do some cleanup, like that sort of stuff. Oh yeah, the first ones to get started. Yeah, so I'll have to look and I'll start putting those on. Maybe I'll try and put like one of those on a night sort of thing. Maybe that'll help. help me get it done. I need to break things up like that. I need to have like smaller tasks versus thinking that, oh, I'm going to just sit down and do the whole big thing. It's easier for me thinking, I'll just do one of these extra a day. So I think I got to start looking at it with that mindset, not that, I'll just sit down and do all of them. The YouTube video starts with block 11. Oh, okay. All right. I'm going to have to build it into my day so to get it done. So I'll start uploading one a day to start out. It takes a little bit of time, so I'm not sure if I can do more than that, but I'll start with number one. I'll just search for where that one is and start there. I think that's what I'm gonna have to do, because yeah, that's been hanging over my head. I've just been wanting to get that on, and I all the old ones up, and I just haven't yet. So time to build it in. Just jump by, miss watching you. Oh no. Well, that's too bad. I'm sorry to hear that. That was nice of you to come in though. I'm just glad they're there to watch later. Yeah, I'll get them all up for sure. So starting tonight, I will put one of them up a night, and you know what? In no time, they'll all be up. So thanks for reminding me again, though, because I just really need to... I need that push to just get it done, you know? So yeah, I'll add that to my... even here when I upload these guys, these newer ones. Do you use chalk pencil? I used, it's basically a chalk pencil. It's a water-soluble marking pencil that's white. Here, I can show you in a sec here. Let me just, yeah, we'll do it now. Let's see. I used this, I don't know, I think I just got this a long time ago at you know, probably Joann's. They come in blue too. They're kind of weird. I mean, they're a little awkward, but, you know, I am using this dark fabric, so they did the job. Oh, my husband doesn't need to see me. just kidding. He works all the time too. So, but luckily we both work from home, so I get to see him during the day. So that's nice. The twirl seam, I think the first time we did that was on the checkerboard block. I believe that's actually block 12, because I think my block was block 11, and I think that one came right after. I'm not sure if that one's up yet, honestly. I'll have to check. But yeah, I'll start at number one and get those up. But I mean, if you're totally needing it, like immediately, the twirled seam, I would go to the Splendid Sampler and look at go to block 11, not block 11, block 12, the checkerboard one. I think there's a link to a tutorial on how to do the twirled seam there too. I mean, I do think tutorials, it's kind of interesting. I appreciate you guys, like, hanging out with me doing this kind of style of video. This is kind of, like, an odd style of video. It's not, you know, it's not like a tutorial where I just show you everything right away and everything. You know, you guys are sitting here this whole time, and I appreciate you doing it with me. Like with this twirled seam is what made me think of it. I think it's actually, it's kind of nice seeing things, I think, as they're happening and not all glossy and perfect all the time, even though sometimes you just need a quick tutorial. You just need to know it right away. And that's what the nice glossy tutorials are good for. And I'm planning on actually doing some videos that are like the quick, like, you know, 1 to 3 minute little things, like how do you do this, there, you're in and out and done. I'm actually planning on doing doing those, but I appreciate that you guys are kind of liking this style too. It's a little different. I mean, like, what I like is that you can kind of, you don't always see just the perfection. You see, like, us trying things, and, you know, even with this, like, what happens if we just use one thread? Does that improve it or not? And you know what I mean? Like, to me, that's what I love about learning. That's how I learn well, is just by trying different things and, like, oh, what if we do this? Or, you know, just asking questions and stuff. And you know, it's neat that you guys sit with me through that, through that learning process. I appreciate it a ton. All right, this guy's done. That didn't take too long. I just have to tie a little knot. Perfection is overrated. I don't like that. That's a good thing. I was writing someone today, and we were talking a little bit about this, and I was thinking that, you know, perfection doesn't really have a place when you're learning. Oh, good, you learned so much. That's so good to hear. You know, I mean, you learn from things not being perfect. I mean, you want to strive for, I mean, you know, strive for perfection, but perfection loosely. Like, you don't want to strive for actual perfection, but you want to be, you want to be striving for that direction, but under the assumption that that's not really a thing that you're ever going to get to, but that's going to allow you to make mistakes and allow you to test theories, you know what I mean? To see if something is going to work or isn't. And all of those are like a step closer to things being better and learning more. And I don't know. So I like that sort of experimental, let's try this and let's try this way of learning. And a lot of times that's from learning from someone else by taking a class can kind of speed that up a little bit, but you should still, it's a whole lot of asking, what if this and what if that, and I just kind of like that. And I like seeing it in action. Oh, block 12 is posted. Okay, so that's the one I think that we did the twirled seams. However, I don't think we did, I'm pretty positive we didn't do that one in one day. The block 12, oh, the twirled seams. I keep saying twisted seams, don't I? Is that what I just said? Yeah, the twirled seams. So that would, the twirled seams would not have come in until the end of that block. So I would look for the last video. It would say something like, finish block 12 on it. I might have even mentioned twirled seams. Oh, it says twirled seams on it. Okay. So, yep. So that one's on there. Thanks for checking. That's awesome. All right. Well, that's good to know. So, by any chance, was it tall? Like the tall, old, the old version? I don't think we were doing these horizontal versions videos yet back then. All the old videos, if you are looking for the old videos, they're all tall, because that was kind of, they were all just Periscope, and that was just kind of the format of, that was like best practices for Periscope right when it was starting out, and so all those videos are kind of tall. Now I'm doing them all horizontal, and they should be more higher def and all that. So yeah, but you should still get the idea. It's just not going to be as, oh, it is. So yeah, so that's one of the older videos then, yeah. It's just not going to be as shiny as these ones. But other than that, they're the same. All right, last little leaf. This is relaxing. I really do enjoy doing this. I can definitely see, you know, if I'm itching for a new project, that I could see taking on a needle turn thing as like my next long-term personal project. You know what I mean? I always like having a big project going on, but my main stuff is like a bunch of little projects. So I don't usually take on more than one giant project, but it's always kind of fun to have one hanging out just to, you know, every once in a while I feel like super inspired to work on a big project, then I can have one available to kind of play around with. That's still my jean quilt that's hanging out here. I mean, you know, I guess this is kind of the big project too, but this one I kind of have scheduled every night, so I know it's getting done and stuff, but my other big project is still that jean quilt that just has to be quilted now. And again, that has a pre-project that needs to happen before finishing that, and that's the, like, total cleaning of my basement, which I'm actually going to work on a little bit tomorrow. But that's where my bigger, I got, like, an industrial sewing machine that I've been playing around with. I haven't used it much yet, but I have stitched some of the quilt, the jean quilt on it, just because, again, you know, it's jeans, and it's going to need to go through all those layers of jeans. I'm trying to get this little part here down. I think I got it now. But yeah, so I want to use that machine, but I got to clean the basement to get to it first. My basement's full of fabric right now, guys. It's kind of crazy. Yeah, I'm really excited about it. Someone, I think I talked about this already, but someone in town had sold it. They listed it on Craigslist a while back. It's probably been a year or so now. Yeah, for sure, at least a year. But I snagged it from her. Oops. So that's the one thing about the one thread is that I'm going to constantly be accidentally taking it off my needle. So it's kind of rumbly outside. I don't know if you guys can hear that at all. I think it might be thunder, but it's kind of weird sounding. It's also kind of the time of night that the red eyes for the airplanes go over, and sometimes they can be really loud. So it's I'm not sure if it's thunder or airplanes or just like a truck or something, but there's been some low rumbles out there. It has been raining a little bit. Gentle rumbles. The thinner thread slips off the needle really easy too. Yeah, but I suppose it's less annoying than, so the thread coming off of the needle is less annoying than having the two strands and one not pulling all the way through compared to the other. Did you do these movies before the Splendid Sampler? Yep, I did. So just not too long. I mean, you know, several months. Let's see. Yeah, about maybe, I don't know, probably 6 months or 4 months or so before the Splendid Sampler. Oh, I could tie it on, that's true. I've never done that before. I could give that a try. How do you get it off then? You just cut it, I'm sure. Once I get past this little bit here that I have folded under already, I'll give that a try. Yeah, so before the Splendid Sampler, I'll tie it on. Never done that before. That's actually a good tip if you're teaching kids how to embroider, is you can, instead of tying a knot on the end, if you just, if you thread their needle and then thread it through the thread again, so like just like if you poke it through and then you're kind of making a knot just from them going through each other, the thread and the needle, then the needle won't pop off for little kids when they're embroidering. Which saves you all the time of having to, alright, it's tied on there now. Saves you from having to thread their needles a bunch of times. Yeah, I think that's thunder. We got some low thunder rumbles out tonight. I'm trying to get the swoop a little bit better. You're not getting my work to me. Nice. Yeah, I'm giving it a go here now. I think it's going to work great. Especially with the one thread, I don't really have to worry about... There we go. Just trying to get that curve a little bit better. I don't have to worry about it not going through the fabric or anything. Oh, very cloudy, but no rain by you yet. Yeah, it started to rain right after we got done grilling some hamburgers, so that was pretty good timing. Just kind of sprinkling. It's funny, I can feel my hands trying to hold the thread here, and after I pull on it, I'm like, oh wait, I don't have to do that. So I won't do it this time. Let's see how it feels to not hold my thread. Or not. To like just hold it in. Yeah, it's just funny. Yeah, I'm going to do that. Just tying the needle, the thread at the end of the needle. I was cloudy by you too in California. Wow. No amount of rain happening there, though. So it seems. My husband's mom is coming up from California, coming up in a couple weeks here. We have a wedding to go to. My husband's cousin is getting married. And it's funny because I've known her forever, like since I was in college. And, you know, she was little then, like in you know, not even junior high or something. So now it's just so funny that, you know, she's graduated college like a while ago and you know, getting married. So I knew her when she was really little still. All right. Just this other edge to go. Got some rain, yeah. I'm just trying to, you know, some of these little seam allowances are being a little stubborn, so I'm just keeping on tucking it under until it's where I want it to be. I'm tacking it down. Those little pointy areas are tough. Just trying to get this curve. There we go. Sometimes it seems like this needle turn is a little difficult to get nice, pretty curves. You have to really get this swoop right and go little by little. Three raindrops there in Northern California. Three little baby raindrops. Yeah, my husband's parents, they're from North Dakota, but they've lived all over California in the north, the way north, the middle, and the south, and so we've got to visit quite a bit of California, which is just so neat because it's so different whatever part you're in. Oh gosh, mud in people's houses. Yeah, that's. Are you talking about down in Louisiana, Illinois, girl? Illinois is by, I grew up in Wisconsin, so we're neighbors. Oh, your husband is out there, down there helping. Wow, that's kind of amazing. I mean, it's really crazy. It's just, that's gotta be one of the scariest things. Just scary and just kind of just, you know, heartbreaking, really. You know. All your own home and, you know, all that. Alright, last little bit here. Yeah, no kidding. Baton Rouge area. All right, here we go. I'll get one more stitch, maybe. We'll do one more in here, and then we're done with these leaves. That went pretty quick. That went real quick. So that only took, I don't need the basting stitches in anymore. Let me pull those out. That only took like a half hour or so to do both of these. Yes, you should craft along again. That'd be awesome. You know, I'm finding more and more, even just like how we were talking with me putting those old videos on YouTube, I'm finding that I have to more and more trick myself, I guess, you know, kind of trick myself into doing this stuff every day. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, I guess it's not really tricking myself, but I have to build it in tiny, tiny increments, you know? Like, if I wasn't doing this in the evenings, you know, doing these periscopes, there's no way I would have made it this far in the Splendid Sampler. I need to know that I'm doing it and I'm for sure going to be there because I know that, you guys are going to be there and stuff too. And, it's keeping me, yeah, routine. It's keeping me on top of it, just doing it every day. And, you know, I'm just here like an hour every day, you know what I mean? And I would have normally, if I wasn't doing this, I'd probably just be like super vegging out and tired in front of the TV, probably, just kind of dozing off, which is just after like a long day, you know what I mean? So instead I'm doing this in the evenings, and I've been saying this, I don't know if I've talked about it a lot during the Splendid Sampler, but I've done more crafting in the past, you know, year that I've been on Periscope or so, working on it every night. And, y'all, that's nice. Yay, you're so sweet. But I've gotten more crafting done by just this commitment of every night during an hour. And the reason it works is because, for me at least, is that this is an hour that would be a lost hour. Like, I wouldn't have been doing anything. Like, I'd be, you know, like, watching TV, like I said, just totally tired, or eating snacks, or just kind of putzing around, trying to work on something in my office, but not getting much done because I'm too tired, or that sort of thing. So this is time that didn't exist, you know, it's magic time, because it was going to be lost time anyway. And I started doing that in the mornings, too. We're going to start this guy. I'm going to just give him, I'm going to baste it on. But I started doing that in the mornings, too. I've started for the past year or so, or maybe a little over a year now, and it's like the best thing that I've done for myself, is I've been getting up early in the morning. And I never was able to get up in the morning. Like, never, ever, ever. I mean, not in elementary school or, you know, high school or anything. I was just always so tired all the time and just could not get up in the morning. And all of a sudden I just decided, you know what? I'm going to get up and I'm going to read in the morning. I love reading, and I hadn't been reading for like a year, like maybe one book a year. And that was like hard work. You know what I mean? Oh, that's cute. That's awesome. that's neat. But yeah, so I hadn't been doing that forever, and I was just like, you know what? I'm gonna get up an hour earlier tomorrow, and I'm gonna make a nice cup of coffee, and I'm going to read my book, and it's okay. You know, there was guilt because I should be, you know, I should be working or getting ready to work or whatever, right? If I'm awake, I should be working sort of thing. And there was like a guilt with that. But I'm like, you know what? This is an hour I would have been sleeping anyway. This is an hour that is not, I don't need to feel guilty for it because I would have just been sleeping. So it's a magic hour, and I'm going to take that magic hour and do whatever I want with it. So I started getting up earlier, and I've been getting up earlier and earlier now. Just to sit and read my book. So I read my book every morning and have my coffee, and that is like my morning. And it's kind of magic to me because I want to do this from the front. That's time that just appeared, you know? I was sleeping and now I am doing this instead. So it was like a magic extra hour. All right, I'm just going to kind of put this, kind of trying to figure out where to tack this. I'm actually reading a couple books. I'm reading that daily painting book. That's kind of, if I pan up here, I have a bunch of like little canvases that I haven't done this daily. I wanted to start painting. Like, I took that painting class. I think I'm just gonna, this basting is kind of weird. I'm just gonna, there's not a lot of room here to baste. So I'm just gonna put like one little backstitch in here. Because I can't baste too close to my edges because then I can't tuck under the seam allowance. So I do have enough space in these leaves. So I'm just gonna put like a little backstitch in the leaf there to baste it. I'll show you kind of close what I did. And I'm going to put one in the other one too. And yeah, I can't baste those stems for sure. So see, you can see my outlines there a little. I got to have enough space in between my basting stitches and, you know, the line, and then that it's bigger than the seam allowance so I can tuck it under without these getting in the way. So I definitely, you know, there's no more space to put them except for right in that leaf. So I just did like a little back stitch and left the ends hanging out. So I'm going to do the same thing over here. And I think that's all we're going to do. Yep. I'm definitely going to have to do some clipping. So this is the block, or this is the little piece that we're going to take some time to do it. There's a few things on here that are kind of a little special. First of all, we have this really tight curve. Luckily, I'll zoom in a little for you guys. So we'll just analyze this for a sec here, and then I'll get chatting again. But so we have this little curve here that's going to be tough to tuck under. Luckily, it's going to be covered up by our flower, so this doesn't have to be all that pretty, this curve, and this curve is going to be covered up as well. The other things to notice is that this comes to a nice point. So we're going to be dealing with a point, and I think there's a special way to do that, and I forgot to look up how to do that before I came on tonight, so we're going to try and figure it out by just figuring it out. These are supposed to be kind of nice curves on the edge. I mean, I didn't do the best job, but, you know, like, this one looks all right. It's supposed to be, like, this nice curve. These come to, a tight point. And then the other thing is these inside bits here. Love the 11 shirt. Have you guys been watching Stranger Things? That show's awesome. Anyway, the girl's name 11 in there. but the other thing to look at is that we got these inside points. So where the leaf is here, this point here is an inside, like it's pointing inside. So we are going to have to clip our fabric so it goes towards there. So otherwise, you know, we can't flip it under. It's too tight to flip. Just basted large stitches, then removed. Oh, as you needle turned. Oh, that's a good idea. You could just leave the stems open on the ends. Yeah, you know what? That's true. I could just leave these open. I might just try and stitch them just to see if I can. Because, you know, we'll have small things to stitch some other time, I'm sure. So it'd be kind of good practice. But yeah, I'm not too worried if they don't turn out or if we just decide to leave them open. But yeah, that's true. I could just do the straightaways and nothing else. Oh, have a nice night. You left yours open? Oh, you got your L shirt from Tea Fury. I'm going to have to look. What does it look like? So you are talking about that, 11. That's kind of funny. I wasn't sure if you were talking about the numbers for the Splendid Sampler. I turned one, but nice night. Oh, it was too bulgy. Oh, okay. All right, so too bulgy. Oops. This is not basting well. Let's line that up again. I'm pulling my basting stitches out. There we go. Yeah, nice. That's nice and flat on there. Are we kind of lined up? We're kind of curved a little bit. Ah, well. We'll live with it. I didn't match up the seams very well. Actually, you know what? That's going to annoy me. I can tell it's getting later because when it gets later and I craft, then my brain wants to go into perfection land. So it's it wanted me to rematch these up. So, ah, well. Bear under. Okay, so maybe I'll just go up the sides of it then. Like what you said. Yeah, because if it's too bulky, I guess you would see the bulk underneath it. All right, there we go. Hopefully that looks a little more lined up. Okay, let's stitch. We'll try and get this guy done tonight. There's a lot going on with this one, though. Okay, so I think my plan is I'm going to start here. Yeah, I am just going to treat these as straight edges. I'm not gonna do this curve. I'm just going to flip it under right away. That'll be easier. So I'm going to start out by just pre-snipping this one already. I won't pre-snip the rest though. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna cut a little snip out of here, almost right up to that where that corner meets. Not all the way, but close. So like within like a 16th of an inch or so. So right like that. So you see, I put that little clipping in there. Clip in the seams, and that's going to allow us to be able to tuck under that seam. If you do anything with, like if you've made a stuffed animal before, or anything that you have to turn inside out that has curves, and I'm going to tie that knot again, that has curves or or points, that sort of thing, and you're turning inside out, like a bag or something like that, you'll deal with clipping curves, like what we're doing here. We're clipping on these little inside parts. We could cut notches on the outside, but I don't think we're gonna need to do that. So I'm not gonna bother doing that. Get a little knot going. But yeah, with just the planning things beforehand, I think I need to, I'm going to build in the time to do these, getting these periscopes up, the older ones. But I wanted to, with the daily painting book, that's the book that I'm reading, I want to start, since my painting class, I've been itching to start doing like, just painting at home here. And I thought a way to do that to keep me doing it would be to try doing that painting every day. Just, you know, build something like how I'm doing my reading and how I'm doing these periscopes. Just something where I feel obligated to do it every day, or that I really, really enjoy it. Well, I know I'm going to enjoy it. I'm just trying to figure out how to fit it in the day. So I have to, like, trick my day into it, you know? So, like, with the periscopes, how we were talking how, oh, I'm just going to have to, I'll do one more of those a day. One more adding of the old ones a day. And then soon they'll be done. It's kind of that attitude. So I got to, how long would you need to paint to make the setup cleanup worth it? So that's the trick. The trick is to have it as set up as possible so there is no setup, is my plan. So I have a little box. I don't know if you guys can see it from here. I'm going to do a Periscope about it, or I'm going to actually do a YouTube video about it, like a little review, but let's see if I can point you guys towards it. All right, you can kind of see, but down here I have like a little box. You can't see it really, but it's called a pochade box, I think. And basically what it is, it's kind of used for plein air painting, which is where people go outside and they paint. But it's a little box that has everything contained right in there. So in theory, I could just open it up and I can have all my paints there already. And since it's oil paint, it's not going to dry overnight. So I just need to... you know, like once a week I could revamp the colors if I'm using like a similar colorway for that week, let's say. And so then all I would have to do is open it up. I wouldn't have to set up anything. I'd open it up and all I'd have to set up is, a little mini still life. Like a little, like, you know, if you know, whatever I'm painting, like a little pot of flowers or, you know, some thread or something. All I'd have to do is set up a still life. And I'm thinking, even to go beyond that, I'm thinking, as far as no setup, I'm thinking that's something I could easily set up the night before. So, like, right before I go to bed, I could have my box out. So, because, like, the thing is, even if I have to open that box in the morning, that would almost be too much work for me and make me not do it. Just like literally to open that box. But if I had it open before I went to bed with my brushes there ready to go and it's just open waiting for me to do it and I have a little still life set up here on the table here or something, then I would do it, I think. So that's kind of my plan. So I've heard with these inside points that you can just kind of swoop underneath. So we're going to try that. So I'm just going to swoop. It's kind of hard to get it, but this, you know, so I'm going to kind of swoop on this side and, you know, I'm kind of getting it a little bit. I think I actually probably needed to snip that a little bit more. Let's try that swoop again. But yeah, so now this side's good, but I need to like get that point down in there more. Yeah, exactly. Setting a timer, something like that. So you know what? I'm going to try and tuck this in a little bit more. I'm just trying to grab it a little, get in there. I want to get that a nice point, so I'm going to try and, you know what, I'm going to try and come up at that point. That inside point there. Because in theory, I want a nice sharp point. Ooh, I'm tangling up here. Let's dangle our thread a little. Hold on here. If I get my finger in there, then it'll help with this twist. I got some weird twist in here. Let's untwist this a bit. All right, I lost my little swoop. I regret to take an extra stitch. Okay, so yeah, I'll do that for sure. So let's do that. Let's get this. I think one thing I needed to do was snip a little bit closer, a little bit a little bit closer to the seam. There we go. So that'll do. I mean, it's a little messy, but we for sure got a nice point in there. So inside and outside points do an extra. Okay, will do. So I did an extra one there already. Oh, this. I gotta come up there too. Alright, now let's get this swoop going again and continue along our way. Alright, there we go. Yeah, exactly. That's the thing. I mean, for me, the more barriers, starting is always the worst, right? I mean, you can get really excited to start something, but if you have to look for something, like, where's my scissors, or, I need to go buy that supply or tool, motivation is going to go away real quick. So, you gotta get over as many of those barriers as you can, so you gotta, like, trick your body. So, like I said, if I have it all set up the night before, then I'm more likely to do it. So, actually, even with all these canvases sitting out here, they were all in a package. And these are kind of chintzy ones. After I get through these, I'll probably buy a little bit nicer things, because I don't know if these are going to last. But that's a different topic. But anyway, getting these were sitting around for like a couple weeks now, and I'm like, you know what? The first step is just to take them out of the package. And that will be one more step closer to me prepping them so I can use them to paint. I have to gesso them and stuff, so I'll do all that prep work, and then after that I'll be ready to, you know, set up my thing and paint. But, you know, just getting them out of the package, I'm like, okay, I'm waiting for my coffee to heat up for a minute in the microwave or something. I can open that package. And just that is like, even that was like a huge mental barrier to get over. Like, oh my God, how am I going to do this? Exactly. If your ukulele's out, you play it. If it's put up, you don't. Exactly. And like, I have to actively trick myself like that. Like, I know that's the case. So I have to do it, you know. Motivation and willpower do not work. That is not a thing. You know what I mean? You have to make it hard to not do it. You know what I mean? If it's all set out and the paintbrushes are there and the still life is set up and you woke up early and you have coffee in front of you, it's going to be hard to not do it. You know what I mean? Because it's right there, kind of yelling at you, you know? But if you have to rely on your own willpower and motivation to start something, those are not handy things. Ooh, baritone ukulele. Oh, for fun. I bet you that just sounds really pretty. Yeah. So I'm doing it with the Splendid Sampler, that's for sure. And I'm doing it with my reading in the morning. I think I got those as pretty good habits. Like, I gotta do it long enough that it's a full-on habit. And I was doing it with exercise for a while, but I've been kind of off that. I gotta get back on the exercise train again. Alright, so here's that. We're coming to a point. But I need to do it. I'd like to do it with this painting, because I would love to start doing, like, daily paintings. You know, quick, you know, an hour-long painting, or even quicker if I can. So I'm just going to put this stitch right in the point here. And we'll definitely do like a couple double stitches in here. All right, so here's that little bit for the corner. I think we're just going to, you know what, first of all, I'm just going to add an extra stitch in here right now. There's a guitar. Like, I would love to learn guitar. We have a guitar that's my husband's. He's trying to learn, too, but he says I'm not allowed to learn until he's tried it. Because he knows that I'm good at these tricks for trying to fit in things during the day, you know what I mean? And he doesn't want me to learn before he learns. So, that's fine. I got other stuff I want to do, like this daily painting and stuff. Oh, too many strings on the guitar. Funny. I actually have a weird problem. This is totally weird, but, you know, guitar, you play, you have the frets and stuff on this side. But I have a problem, like, I can't physically bend my pinky if I'm holding this finger. So, like, here, this is just, like, a really weird thing. So, I can bend my pinky here, right? Just fine. But if I'm holding this finger and I'm full-on locking the joint, I can only move at the finger, or at the base of my finger here. I can't bend my pinky at all. Like, I can bend it down, but I have, like, I have no function in it. Unless I move this finger with it, which is totally weird. Like this finger, I can do it. I can bend it just fine. I mean, not great, but I can bend it. This one, I can't at all. So that would be a lot of trouble with guitar, because I need to be able to move this finger independently of the other finger. Oh, good for a good pianist. I took a piano lessons when I was little, but I don't know. That's a lot. That's a lot of stuff. All right, let's try and tuck this point under. We're kind of getting towards the end here too. You know, I wonder if we should just kind of hold off here for the night and let's get through this point. You know what? Let's get through up to one side. So we're going to do this point, interior point here, and then go off this little straight edge like what we did here, and then that's a good stopping point. I don't want to stop in the middle now. There, I'm swooping this point under. So if you pull on that point just to get it real nice, and I'm going to tuck this under again. Just trying to stab it to help me swoop it under. Ooh, I think this point's going to actually look really nice. I think I got it under enough to do one stitch. Then we can keep going. Yeah, okay, that point's going to look great. Like, we got a nice sharp point there. All right, before I get too much farther, though, I'm going to need to snip into here, because we're going to come up to that really, really quickly. So I'm just going to snip again right to that inside point. I'm about 3 or 4 threads away from it, from that interior point there. The hubs just came in the door and he's soaking wet and I can hear it just pouring outside, so. Poor guy. So the thunder has some rain with it. All right. So we're headed towards this interior curve here. You know what? I'm going to get rid of this basting stitch. I don't think I need it anymore, and it's kind of getting in my way. So there we go. And a couple, like maybe 2 more stitches to get to the point here, and then just that straightaway, then we're done. Oh, look how little this leaf is turning out. It's going to be so cute. I'm excited for this tiny leaf. It's so little. I've never done an applique this small before, a needle turn applique. I mean, you know, I've just done the heart applique before this. So it's just kind of fun to do this little one. I mean, we are doing that bunny had very, very small applique pieces, but I'm not that far on the bunny. I haven't got to the point of stitching it on yet. And it's a little different. We did it that version of needle turn applique where we turn it all before we put it on the fabric. This is more traditional where it's actual needle turning. We're using our needle to turn the applique. So it's a little different too. So this is my tiniest guy. Oh, I've done those before, those sipping paints. They're called different things in different places, but they're becoming so popular. I did it I've done it twice, and they're both for wedding showers. Yeah, it's basically that thing where you have an instructor kind of walking you through a painting, and everyone does the same painting. I mean, it's kind of weird, but it's surprisingly fun and relaxing too at the same time. It's weird because you don't really, you know, it's just, you don't really get to make decisions really. I mean, you get to make little decisions along the way of how you want something to look. I think I gotta cut this a little bit more to get into that point there. This is a pretty sharp interior point. But everyone's painting does end up looking a little bit different, which is kind of cool. Yeah, so it's really popular with wedding showers, like the whole wedding, which is just so funny. I mean, it makes me happy because then I just love when people decide that they can do creative things, and it forces, you know, like the mother-in-laws and aunts and whatever that don't think they're creative at all, they have to go to the wedding shower and work with paint and stuff, and then they realize that, oh, this is actually fun. And I just love the idea of people doing creative things, like things, and even better that it's out of their comfort zone, you know? All right, I'm going to have to do this swoop thing again, because I think I just can't get this point, and I think maybe it's because I forgot to do this swoop. I think guys can go too. It's actually, it's a, like a date night thing, actually. I think that's what most people use it for. Like, I could see it being like a first date type of thing. But yeah, I've definitely seen guys there before. The two times that I've done it for the wedding showers. One of the wedding showers was in a private room, but the other one was just part of their daily, you know, group that comes in. And it was definitely a date night thing for some people. And then, you know, a girl's night out or a work party sort of thing, too. They're totally weird. Like, you go there and you feel super weird. And they're, you know, they're usually in these horrible split spaces sometimes and stuff, too. But once you get going, it's just so corny, too, because, you know, you have this teacher and you just feel awkward and weird. But, you know, everyone feels that way. And it ends up being just so fun, and everyone just gets a kick out of it once you're going, and you get a look around at everyone's, and it's very fun. Well, that's okay to just laugh. That's what the wine and beer is for. It's funny, we have they're all like individually owned, you know, so it's all, they're all different things. I think one of them I went to was called the Paint Pub. So that one was more, oh, well, that's a baby shower, wedding shower thing. But if it's just like, if you go for a date night thing, then, you know, then it's a little different. The Paint Pub was one. And what was the other one called? They all have like, you know, silly, clever names. Wine. I don't remember what the other one was called. Wine and Canvas. That, I'm not sure if that's the one that we're at. You know what? That might have been it. That one's not so clever, though. People have easily amused. That is cute. That's funny. I like that. Easily amused. Beer and Brush for Men. Oh, that's kind of funny. Yeah, I thought the Paint Pub was kind of cute. All right, I have a little raw edge hanging out here that I'm not too happy about. It's just because our seam allowance is so small. Once we snip that edge, I'm going to try and tack it down. So I'm going to just go down, come back up, and try and tack it in there. Easily amused. It's pretty dang cute. So I think I can just tuck it under and tack it down, and hopefully that will help that seam allowance. All right. Let's go back into this corner area. I think I've tacked my corner down way more than I needed to, though, but, you know, it's a little difficult, this little inside corner. And I think, you know, it's a little bunchy too, but I think after, here too is the seam's just a little much. You know what, I'm going to go backwards a little and try and get that. I kind of thought these would be the trickiest parts of this, and you know what, the flower parts on here have a lot of little spiky points and inside points like this too, so we'll probably come upon this issue again, like with the seam allowance trying to pop out the tiny little bits that are left of the seam allowance. I think I got it under now. The stem gave you a hard time? Yep, it's giving me a hard time. So there, I mean, I'm not done. I have a few more stitches to go up here, but I just wanted to show you. Let's try and get in focus here a little bit. My points. So I do have, like 12 more of these or something like that. All these points, because I have all these other flowers. I am happy with this point though. Oh, thanks for coming in, Janelle. All right. So I do like my point up here though. So that's kind of fun. But yeah, these inside points. They'll get better though as I go, I'm hoping. So I'm just going to put another one here to get back on track. And I think maybe two more and we'll be done soon here tonight too. I'm just going to go up this side. I'm not going to do the whole other side. Yeah, we're kind of, just check my watch, we're way over. I don't always, you know, in my head these are, you know, I'll be here for 50 minutes or so, but it always ends up being like, lately it's been like an hour and 10 minutes. But there we go. I'm just going up to the edge again. I'm just going to go up to right to here. That'll be good. Because all this is going to get covered by, I'm not doing these tight curves because those are all going to be covered up by flower parts. So I think this will look a little bit better once we, press it a little bit again. You have the middle pieces and the round pieces left. Oh, nice. So you're way far done. So I'm just going to tie a little knot here. And you know what? I'm not going to tie a knot here on the back because I'm not done. I just have to go down to the other side. So I'm just going to stick the needle in here and we'll pick that up tomorrow. Yeah, tomorrow's Wednesday. We have one more day to work on it, and then before we get the next block, Thursday's block. So I just kind of want to peek. Aw, I like these little flowers. Those stems are a bear. Yeah, I'm kind of happy that we're getting it done early. On the inside point, wrap your thread around the applique. Oh, I missed that. So on the inside point, wrap around the applique, and then does that pull it in somehow or something? We'll do it again tomorrow. So we have, you know, 2 points on this one and then 4 points on each of these other guys. So, you know, that's 14. We have 14 more chances to practice this inside bit. So do what again? I can look it up on YouTube when I'm done. Like I can rewind on YouTube to see what you said if you don't want to type it all in again. But, something about, grabbing the applique or something. I'll look it up. But all right, there we are for tonight. I really like how symmetrical this flower sits with these guys. I'm excited about this one. I really am. I think I've never done anything really pretty and traditional like this. So, all right, guys, I'm going to flip you around and we'll call it an evening. Hey, so here it is. So we got one side going and, you know, I like that point. We're working on it. We'll just get better. You know, I think these guys got better after I did it for a little while. Yeah, that's how tiny they are. Seriously. They got a lot tinier once we started stitching them, but I'm loving this process. I mean, I know that this is going to be one of those blocks that I have unfinished for a long time. But you know what? I'm liking it. It's fun. It's relaxing. So this will go up on YouTube. It'll be at Penguin and Fish Movies. I'll get that up tonight. And I will get, I'll start putting the first blocks that I don't have up yet on YouTube. I'll start getting those up. I'll do the first one of those tonight as well. Block number one, the first video, if I can find it. But I'll start getting those up again now, too. So, all right, guys. I will see you tomorrow, Wednesday. Have a great day. And thanks for coming in tonight.